Dr. Megha told, I am working last 30 years, I work at CSIR CMAP, and you, some people may be knowing about the our institute. As CSIR having near about 37 labs, working in the different field, and our institute is mainly involved in the medicinal aromatic plant based our institute. It is a prime institute in India, working in the field of medicinal and aromatic plants. And initially, I will brief about the some institute activity. You people is hearing me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, sir. Okay. So, our institute is generally main aspect we are working A, B, C, D. A means agriculture, B means biology, C means chemistry, and D means drug development. So, our mainly activity is focused. Because this is an agriculture-based institute, so generally we are developing the technology for our farmers, agro-technology for enhancing the yield, how to cultivate the medicinal aromatic plant, why, how much fertilizer required, how much the resistance, how much irrigation, what is the weeding, and other agriculture technology. So CSIR CMAP developed the technology of newly developed variety as well as improved agro technology for old variety for the generally for our farmers. And as a biological activity, CSIR CMAP is developing the high yielding varieties of medicinal and aromatic plants. As you know that our institute is working in the medicinal aromatic plants, so we developed a lot of varieties, high yielding varieties of medicinal aromatic plants. And in the area of chemical science, generally we developed the technology to how to actually, you may be knowing that these crops may not be sale is directly. Medicinal aromatic plant has to be processed either in the form of essential oils. If aromatic plants, its final product is essential oils. If herbs, so it is processed as either herbal extract or processed herb can be marketed. So in our chemical division, we are developing the technology how to enhance the quality and quantity of the oils and herbal extract while developing the new method or new equipment for extraction. On the other hand, our chemist is involved to increase the quantity of active molecules in the plants by different method. Under drug development, we developed lot of OTC herbal product by utilizing the medicinal aromatic plants as a one major or one or more major active ingredient. Initially, because some of you may not be knowing about the CMAP major achievement, CMAP having lot of achievement with the name, but I will tell some few only. You may be knowing the about the mint crop, menthol mint. Previous year, long back, we had to import the menthol either oil or menthol as a crystal from US or China, and we depended only in other country, but our institute has taken this crop as a challenge and developed lot of improved varieties and agro technologies. And you may be happy to know that nowadays last many years we are the number one position in the world. So we are producing near about 80% of total world requirement of oil, menthol oil. So we are now controlling the all menthol mint market. So it is a very good achievement of CSIR CMAP, making the independent, and also lot of. We are earning lot of money by exporting the menthol based product. Second crop, Artemisia annua. This crop basically belongs to China continental. and our directors brought this crop and start cultivation in India. And we, because this is a major crop, using it for making the drug of, for malaria. And we start cultivation some few years back, and contract farming for some industry started with our farmers. And now we are growing export to China. So we are now, whatever China is producing, we are producing somehow not less than China, at par with China. We have, and we are independent for artemisia requirement. Also, we are exporting this. Third crops, we work on geranium cultivation. Geranium is a very high value crop and generally used in cosmetics and other perfumery and also in soap industry for using the aroma, for giving the aroma, rose base aroma. So because you may be knowing that rose oil is quite high value, that is near about 12 to 13 lakh rupees per kg. So whatever generally most of the people using rose aroma in cosmetics using the geranium oil. So it is the called the Indian rose also, and we start this cultivation in because this is a temperate climate crop. It can be grown very well in hills, and it is a perennial crop. So we start the cultivation this Uttarakhand and other hilly areas and under the bio village project. So this is the also a very profit and change the socio-economic status of the lot of farmers. One more crop, CMAP verb, that is a vetiver. Vetiver is a crop, it can be grown in any land, either is sandy lawn, sandy soil, or sodic or saline soil. So wherever is the sea belt or Ganga belt, or even though people is having land, their other crops cannot be grown, this vetiver can be grown. It is very hardy crop. If water is stand in the field for a long period, that crop may not get disturbed or may not get damaged. It will survive. So wherever our farmers is having profitable land like a usar, like a saline or sodic, our farmers is growing the vetiver and getting the good income. CSIR CMAP last few years, last 2 years, we are working in Aroma Mission. Aroma Mission is a very dream project of CSIR, and you know that our Prime Minister's dream is to enhance the income of our farmers. So Prime Minister wants that double or triple the income of the our farmers under Aroma Mission. You people may be knowing that cultivating the traditional crops, either wheat or paddy, may not be that much profitable compared if you add their investment, how people is investing the cultivation cost, irrigation cost, fertilizer cost, seed cost, but people is not calculating their labor. Generally, what farmers is doing, they are doing their, they are themselves, they are cultivating, so they are all family members is working in the field, but they are not calculating their labor cost. If they calculate their labor cost, then these crops are not much profitable, not a profitable crop. So we recommend generally people go for growing the high value aromatic crop. So this Aroma Mission generally brought to enhance the income of our farmers, and under this we have targeted 5,000 hectares area has to be planted shortly, and we started this work under the aromatic crop. But other hand, we need grain crops and as well as pulses also for our own requirement. If we are not growing the wheat or paddy, then what we will eat on pulses? So we recommend our farmer, please cultivate our crops. Either your land is vacant where no other crop is growing that time. So we are having some short period crop also, like tulsi. Tulsi can be grown for a within a 50 days. So this is a 50 days crop, and if any farmers having the field vacant for a 50 days, they can go for that Tulsi cultivation and they can earn very good amount between that. And other thing, if you have a cropping system growing like this, wheat, paddy, between that you can adjust our crop like mentha and other crop. So our farmers generally in India, marginal farmers is taking two or maximum crop in their field. So sometimes their field is vacant, so they can adjust our crop under good cropping system. Next, we recommend that where paddy and other crop cannot be grown, please grow our crop in that area. So generally these our like our aromatic grasses, palma roja, lemon grass, vetiver, even though citronella, these crop can be grown in saline or sodic land also, and waste land also. So we recommend our farmers, wherever you don't have any cultivation, please cultivate our crop, take this high value crop and earn the more money. CSIR CMAP has developed one very good technology, especially for household women and self-help group. Because people is generally offering the flower in gods, and due to our segment that due to our this because this flower offered to God, we cannot throw this flower on road. So and if you are putting in river, that we are you are getting the pollution. So CSIR CMAP developed the technology by utilizing this flower for making the agarbatti. So generally women is collecting this flower free of cost from the temple, and by the utilizing our technology, they are making agarbatti and earning lot of money. So this our program changed lot of socio-economic status of the women in surrounding so many place, and this initially we started in surrounding Lucknow, but now this is this scheme is started so many temples like Sai Baba temple, like Balaji temple, like Ajmer Sharif, and Meenakshi temple, and so many Vaishno Devi temple. This scheme now started, and lot of our poor women having now good amount of money, earning good of amount of money by utilizing our this technology. Actually today my topic is herbal formulation and quality control. So what is the herbal formulation? Generally, formulation contain one or more molecules from herbs or plants, active ingredient called herbal formulation, and they are having some specific direction that in herbal formulation 15% chemicals and other things you can utilize, or minerals you can utilize it, but your active ingredient should be from plant based. So why we have developed lot of nutraceutical cosmetics and other thing, and the active ingredient we used in herbal formulation has to be prepared either extraction, plant extraction, distillation, essential oils hai, distillation, extraction, fractionation. Agar oils hai, toh their fractionation like lemon grass, we can fractionate like a citral. So we can use a citral as a active ingredient, purification, concentration. So lot of method for making the raw material, prepared the raw material for using the either making powder or other thing. So whatever product we are making by using the plant based material called herbal. And you know that quality control is the major issue in the Ayurvedic formulation or especially herbal formulation. Previously, what our Grantha said, people is making Ayurvedic drug by utilizing whole plant as such. But nowadays, there's generally people is collecting herbs from wildly, from forest. And collection of forest from for raw material is a very challenging job, because nowadays people doesn't know physiology of the plant. They know they are collecting the plant, but that looking maybe like Brahmi, lot of confusion is there. People is collecting the plant and they are not actually Brahmi, but looking like a Brahmi. So sometimes collection of plant from wild areas give the wrong information, give the wrong raw material, and that may not reflect the activity in the product. So quality control is the major issue. First, RADRA means raw material, whatever you're using. So first we should go for quality control. What is the raw material, is having a specification or not? Then after raw material, final product has to be go through quality control parameters. Otherwise, it cannot be exported. Your product cannot be exported, cannot be marketed. So quality control is the major issue in the field of herbal, because we are using the raw material plant-based. Plant-based means lot of difference in variety itself. If you are using any herbs and they are different variety, in different variety also content may be a differ. So please see before going this, that whatever fingerprint we are providing to any technology wire or other thing, so utilize the same fingerprint planting material, so maintaining the quality control. These are the parameter for quality control. Physical evaluation, after seeing by the microscopic or by your hand, by eyes, or so many physical parameters you can see looking also. Second, chemical evaluation. Chemical evaluation, for chemical analysis you have to done GLC, HPLC, HPTLC. So that you know that what content you require, it is available or not. Or biological evaluation, that pharmacological activities like S value, also acid value, like etc. So you can see the product raw material, this crude drug, is as per your standard or not. This is the parameter of quality control: macro, microscopic examination, foreign organic matter, S value, moisture content. Moisture content also play a major role in any quality control. If you are taking the any herb and it contains the moisture, it will get infected by bacterial infection or fungal infection. So generally, whatever people is buying the herbs from market, it is not properly moisturized, properly moisture content is mentioned. Or secondly, that their packing and storage also give the deterioration in the planting material. Extractive value of the plants, crude, quantitative and chemical evaluation, chromatography examination, quantitative chemical evaluation, toxical study also. So these are the parameters you have to go for any quality or herbal drug as well as raw material. Now I will tell about the formulation developed by the CMAP. Actually, CMAP is the last few years we have worked to whatever our farmers is growing the medicinal aromatic plant, it's required the market, because this crop is not a common crop. Farmers can sell in any market like a paddy or wheat. It is a specific crop and it's required specific market also. And it's for generating market, we have developed a lot of formulation for creating the market for our farmers. It If you classify our formulation, we have skin care formulation, we are having hair care formulation, we have disinfectant, we have mosquito repellent, we have pain reliever formulation and nutraceuticals and some other also. In skin care formulation, this is we have developed crack nail. This is a anti-crack cream, and this anti-crack cream developed by utilizing our traditionally known turmeric, and we have used some basilicum tulsi oil in this, and some other oil combination. And you see, we have patented this. We got the patent, US patent, Japan patent, and European patent also for this product. We did this clinical trial also in 2-3 hospitals surrounding Lucknow, and we found that this product is effective against severe cracks on the heels. We have cured these severe heel cracks also in this. And it is very effective product. This and very safe product. And this these are having the beauty that cracks doesn't occur again. So it is kill the fungus permanently. We have Mycodil. This is also a one antifungal cream. What this cream we can use, this is a broad spectrum antifungal cream, use on the other part of the skin where you are having the fungal infection on your other body part. You can utilize this cream for the antifungal activity, and we got the US patent and Indian patent also for this product. In this we have specifically used the one oil of mentha variety, that called Ganga, and that variety developed, a specific variety developed by the CSIR Seaman. We have all purpose cream. It is a antiseptic cream. This again we have used turmeric, aloe vera and other essential oils combination of this. It is also a like cold cream. You can use as like antiseptic cream. This formulation where you have the cracks on your hands or lips and other part also, you can use this cream. Kilenji is a aloe vera based face mask, and this is a generally nowadays youngster is not using soap on their face. So lot of demand is liquid face mask. So we have developed this liquid face mask. It is anti, this remove the dirt and germs also from your skin and provide very freshness. In this we have used aloe vera. So it will maintain moisture also in your skin. And this is in two aroma we have used. One is lemon, other is fruit. Other skin related product, this is skin gel. This is also a aloe vera and rose oil based, rose water based formulation, but it is a, we have put the activity from other plant extract and essential oil, and it is a having near about 40 this is generally we use for skin burn. So SPF factor is 40. So this is plant based first product. Your sun protection factor is 40. So we have not used any single chemical in this. This is plant based, and this is anti having the anti aging property also. Acne preventive face mask. Acne is also a major problem for youngster, and neem face mask of Himalaya. Because you may be knowing that neem face mask is the second largest selling product of the Himalaya after Li 52. So we developed this formulation taking the best marketed product, and we found this our formulation is four times better than against acne bacteria compared to all the marketed product. So this is only again herbal plant based aloe vera is there, and some other activities we have taken from the essential oils and some extract, and it gives a very good effectiveness against the acne bacteria. Lip balm. Nowadays, young, especially girls, like this lip balm. It's very popular in the market, and many companies from out of India marketing this product and charging near about 8 gram package, 400 to 500 rupees. Even though body soap is also 280 or 70 rupees for 8 gram package. This formulation